Quant 2.1 is an exciting new open source video model that allows you to generate short form videos. However, using the model with no optimization techniques can significantly increase inference time. Today, we'll be using Quant 2.1 text-to-video model along with Teacache to make inference up to 2 times quicker. So to get started, you need to download the appropriate model files. So this will include a text encoder, a VAE, along with a video model. Now, all these must be placed in the appropriate directory here. As far as the quality of the video model, there are several to choose from. We're just going to be looking at the text-to-video model today, but even within text-to-video, you'll find that there is either a float point 16 all the way down to a float point 8. Now, to get those files, you can head over to Hugging Face and go to the Quant 2.1 ComfyUI repackaged repository and download the appropriate files there. If I jump over to my ComfyUI instance, you'll also want to make sure that you install Comfy node called Teacache. So you'll find that here. Just have that installed onto your machine. Now, if you have any problems running this custom node, you might need to update ComfyUI. I believe it requires at least a version of ComfyUI 3.34 or later. So if you have any errors with this, just note that. So to confirm, we have all the files in the appropriate directory, and I will reference the ComfyUI workflow here from time to time during this tutorial, but we're basically building it out from scratch and just kind of walking you along. So first we'll do the load diffusion model, and we can see our text to video model, and then we're gonna bring in our Teacache. So Teacache is just this one node, and that will optimize the entire thing. And so it's pretty straightforward. You'll just change this model type to Quant to text to video, 14 billion parameters. Now, as far as with these values, you will have to set these based on the repository on GitHub here. If you scroll all the way down, you'll see what those values should be. So for the text to video model, which we're using, we'll set this to 0.2, then to 0.1, and then an n% of 1. So let me hop back over. 0.2, 0.1, and I'm going to change this cache device to CPU because in some testing ahead of time, I was getting some allocation errors. So if you have any sort of errors there on your machine, you might want to take a look at that setting. So next, we'll take in the model SD3, the model sampling SD3 node. So this isn't specific to Stable Diffusion 3. But since Quant is a flow matching model, it's a little bit different of an architecture, you can kind of help guide the sampling process. I believe the default value that ComfyUI provides and their default workflow is 8, so we'll kind of stick to that. Then we'll bring in the K sampler and connect that. Next, we'll bring in load clip, and then we have our clip model there. We'll change this to Quant. And then we'll bring in our text encode, which is basically just our positive and negative prompts. So this is all pretty familiar if you're using even Stable Diffusion 1.5 or SDXL. We'll just connect these into the K sampler. Now, just a couple of tweaks here. I'm going to use a fixed seed value, set it to 20 steps. The recommended CFG is 6. And then for the sampler name, we want to change this to UniPC. This is important. Same with the scheduler, we'll change this over to simple. And as far as with latent image, we'll go to Hunyuan empty and bring that into our latent image input. Now, a couple of notes here. So first up is the length. So the length is basically how many frames we're going to generate. Quant recommends 16 frames per second plus 1 in total. So for example, if we're going to do a 2-second video, that would be not 32 frames, but 33. And as far as the width and height, it's recommended to use multiples of 16. So we're going to kind of go with something in the neighborhood. So I have this little aspect ratio tool. I'll provide a link in the description if you find it handy, because sometimes I struggle with math. And we'll do 720, which is divisible by 16. Now the height is not divisible by 16, but ComfyUI, I believe this node, will round it to make it work, and then we'll have an adequate output. And then as far as the latent output, we got to decode that from the latent space, and then we also need to load our VAE. Lastly is our animated save animated webp. So this basically saves the final output from one. So we'll change this to 16 frames per second, which is what we're expecting from the model. And I'll leave these others as default, but you could change the quality if you wanted as well too. So as far as with the prompt, and you can play around with this if you want, but from the official workflow, they have this, which one is a Chinese-based video model. So I couldn't find the backstory on this negative prompt if it is officially recommended from Juan, but it's very reminiscent to Stable Diffusion prompts, especially Stable Diffusion 1.5. I tossed this into Google Translate, and you can see a lot of the same sort of terms like deformed, disfigured, malformed, poor quality, and so on within this negative prompt. So for our positive prompt, I'm going to do just a simple test. So I'm going to say a man standing in a New York City street in the background, yellow cabs. So we have in the street, I probably should say on the sidewalk, but hey, let's just go with it and see what we get. And then I will cue the prompt. So let me get that started. So after only 1 minute and 20 seconds, we have our output. Now that typically would have taken about 3 to 4 minutes previously without Teacache. And as we can see here, it's fairly representative of what the prompt was. Now there are of course a little bit of weirdness going on in the background, and we can always try to refine this further, but I'm overall really pleased with the results. So as far as all the files and configurations, I have all links to that in the description if you need any help with that. And of course, if you have any questions, drop it in the comment section below. Again, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.